From November 6, 1968 to March 20, 1969, students at San Francisco State College took part in a massive demonstration.
And it was a part of the civil rights movement. At that time, we were looking for two things: getting minority students into the school, and then the second had to do with establishing a school of ethnic studies.
We wanted to increase the representation of third world students because there were so few. There were officially, I think, 75 Filipinos on the campus.
Black, Latino, Asian, and others came together to form the Third World Liberation Front. Through this movement, the Filipino American Collegiate Endeavor was formed.
The purpose of PACE was political. It was to become involved so that Filipinos in particular could be represented. And it was both on the campus and off the campus.
The Filipinos who grew up here, like myself and other people who were born here, they grew up and saw the racism in the system, their otherness. They were different from everybody else, right? So they were forced to look into decolonization processes.
The strike became a national issue, especially when police were shown assaulting students.
You gotta remember, at all times, the cops were armed. They had guns and they had batons. They had tear gas. They had experimental thing called mace. And they had experimental pepper gas, okay? And they're bringing all that stuff to the campus and looking for a reason to use it.
Students claimed victory as the College of Ethnic Studies was formed. The strike also motivated students across the country to demand that ethnic studies be taught on their campuses.
I foresee that this is going to continue to go on for decades, which is really good. It's a very small segment of history, but it's certainly an important part.
Celebrations of the student strike have been going on since last fall. On April 20th, a special gala dinner will celebrate the Asian American Studies Department, with a keynote speaker being undocumented Filipino filmmaker and SF State alumni, Jose Antonio Vargas. Ramel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.